And we attract talent by winning awards. And I think that's a main driver, especially for getting application from outside of Denmark. It is the awards. That's the only touch point we have, you could say, with those potential talents.
Hi, my name is Victor, and I'm a creative living in Copenhagen, Denmark. I love to talk to other creatives. So a couple of months ago, I decided to start going around town, but I decided to bring my camera with me so that I get to share these little chit chats with people like yourself. And this is the result of that. So these interviews that I've been doing so far, they all sort of revolve around design in one way or another. And I just want to keep it as low key, but in depth as possible. In this interview, I'm talking to Pelle Martin, the CEO and the founder of Spring Summer, which is one of the most famous digital agencies here in Copenhagen. In this video, he talks about the history of Spring Summer, the industry in general in Denmark, design and winning awards, and why are they important, if they are important. So enjoy the video.
I am the CEO and founder of Spring Summer, and my role in the daily, the day-to-day things is to have a creative director role where I'm involved in the projects. I sometimes design some stuff myself. It's like the design heritage that's kind of made me what I am today and what we are as a company today. And then I have a ton of administration stuff. So of course, also just running a company is something that takes a bit of work as well. Started working for Victoria's Secret as a freelancer, edited by Stella McCartney, three seasons for a company called Jen Lane in the US, freelancing. And some of those experiences kind of boiled down to what I thought Spring Summer could be. And that's kind of how it started. The Spring Summer name came about a little bit before that. So actually we had a small freelance setup called Spring Summer where we had George Jensen, a Danish jewelry company, as a client. We had a few other small clients, and around that we formed Spring Summer. But in 13, I kind of had the idea that now Spring Summer could be my dream of a company and be built from the ground up as a way that I thought you could make a good business model around being ambitious and happy about your output, having a family kind of setup in a company. I would say we are a design agency at heart, but we do brand work like identity, full identities, motion graphics in some cases, content design for our solutions. Most of the projects we have, there's kind of a website in the middle because that is our heritage. I think that is where we can stand out. Companies would come to us for a tailored digital solution that stands out. And I think we are quite good at extending the brand experience into the digital world. I thought I could do something more pure on my own. So that's actually what led to Spring Summer in some way. I really enjoy having young talent that emerges and kind of exposes the real talent in a team. Working as a freelancer, I was kind of missing that for a while. Starting the company, I got that back, you would say. I think just the relationship with the clients is extremely important in creating good work, getting to know them. Of course, you can do that when you're hired at a company. It is a totally different feeling when it's your own company. And I try to get that feeling out into everybody's hearts here in the company, but it is special when you own it yourself. You have, your heart is in the company and in your work in a different way. It's of course you get clients through your network and they know you for certain things. I mean, I was maybe getting a little bit of a name in the Danish world around digital design, and we Spring Summer could kind of work on the employees' personal brand, you could say, for a while. But now Spring Summer has a name, so now it's more the company that's well known. There's a golden rule, apparently I've just heard this, but it takes around 5 years for a company to move the you could say the brand knowledge out into the client's sphere around it. And we could actually feel that. It was around when we got 5 years old that we began to be a normal agency and compete with the other agencies on their terms, you could say. I think the best work we can do is when I step back a little bit and I more use my skills as input, think we reach good results with that. I really enjoy when when what I do kind of feeds into designer or the art director working on it and the developer as well. And they kind of take ownership. But in some cases, I've just been the designer at a project. We've had one called 100, where I was more actively designing the site. We have Simply Chocolate, which I think is one that stands out for us as a key piece of work. Won a Site of the Year award at Awwwards, and it's one of the sites where everything kind of added up into one unity in some way, and it feels like a very complete solution in some way. And it still looks new, even though it now has a couple of years on it. It doesn't have any fashion in there, which I also like. It's not web design fashion. It's just designed around ideas about how to present a product in a good way. A lot of the projects we do right now, we do everything in-house. We are actually staffed in a way where it's ideally half of the projects are developed by other people than ourselves. Because we have more designers than developers. If we were to do everything ourselves, we would actually have more developers than designers. Because there is just more work in development than design too. But we also have clients like American Express, where we don't do any development at all ourselves, only prototyping and stuff. Other clients where they have just a development set up around them. And then in some cases we take part in pitches where get invited to the creative part, and then they invite developer houses to pitch in for the technical part, and then we get matched with somebody. For them, we actually work with future scenarios. So we work with two teams, and both teams work with how their digital work will look in 3 to 6 years in the future. So it's super exciting, but not a lot of what we do actually becomes reality, because it's all the time like way out in the future. But a lot of the look that they have now kind of comes from some of the first work we did for them. So you could definitely see our fingerprint in what's out there now, but very different client for us. And in some cases, high fidelity prototypes, fully developed. We spent 1.5 years developing a release candidate for our app, developed in React, and it was never released. So it was like a lot of work going into something that doesn't emerge into the real world. I think it's almost in every project in some kind of way, and it's that little detail. It's often a thing that you would label as a UX thing, I think. Like visual design on its own can only have that much impact. I think the UX, the interactions, the way that you structure things can have a much bigger impact in the end result. It's not necessarily UX comes from a UX designer, it can come from anybody. For that Simply Chocolate website I talked about before, it's the idea here is unwrapping Simply Chocolate. So here it's about having the chocolate in packaging. When you go into one, you start peeling up off the packaging, and when you scroll, you take it off and snap off a piece of the chocolate. And when you look inside the chocolate, you also read about the nutrition in the chocolate. So it's all connected in some way. That kind of feeling where it just connects, and that very natural approach actually to design and flows, I think works really well for us. And it's often in the case where you solve that, where you get that aha moment and think that this will probably be a good project, and it kind of gets everybody up and going and really motivated to do good stuff. Yeah, I think it can be, it's obvious when it happens. It's not necessarily obvious leading up to it that it's going to come now, but it's one person with a good idea in some meeting of most of the times. Other times it's one person sitting with a design or a UX process or even development, where it's the best feeling when it does, and it's best peak moment inside a project as well. And then you kind of hope that the client can see it as well, because it's not always that it survives all the way through. So if the client doesn't really appreciate the perfect idea that we come with, I think when I was younger, I had a really hard time with that. And I think I can feel when we have young people at the company, they fall so much in love with their ideas and the work that we do, that it could be a hard hit to move on. But I've learned to enjoy it in some way, just say like, what, I mean, because very often the next idea is even better. So it's not necessarily a bad thing. It's a bad thing if we spend too much time, of course, as a business, with the business goggles on. But we can actually use it very often. And I think it's also something I really try to underline here, that the clients, they really know their clients and their business better than we do. And it's, I mean, it's super important that we listen to them. In some cases, they are not right, of course, but they are actually quite often right in what they say. So we need to work with that and still pull it off, you could say, and make it even better. We launched a project for III, which is a Danish headphone company, and they make modular headphones, and they're super nice. And they have had really nice digital work out from other agencies, but now we got the opportunity to do a new main platform for them. We haven't announced it ourselves. We don't have it on our website still because we're still making the final adjustments and they actually develop it themselves. The result of that site, I think, just really, really nails and elevates the brand that they have. They're also very in the middle of the DJ community and they have a nerdy like crowd of people who buy headphones, and getting in those nerdy bits into a site like this, I think, has really worked well. And it's also just working with typography and colors. It's not very animated at all. It's more design, it's more layout, more compositions, these kind of things. And especially there's like this configurator of the products that are just, I think, works really well now, where it's really been lifted from what they had before. I'm really proud of that. We're going to submit it to Awwwards. I think it will do well. We also did another project for something called UIA. It's a congress of architects happening in 3 years, in 2023, where the 17 sustainability goals are kind of mixed together or matched with projects in the architectural world. And I think we pulled that off in a nice way. It's very minimalistic, very simple site, but also uses the real estate of the screens really well and gives the client good opportunities to work with the site over 3 years, which is kind of a special thing. So, thing as well. It's a white background, very typography based. We looked at architectural drawings, took elements from that into the design and kind of used things that has worked for architects over the last like 50 or 100 years maybe, and used that as the design elements to make sure that it can stand the test of time. I think those two stand out, then we have some more flashy stuff. But it's also been a year where we've worked on some big clients, so and some of them hasn't even launched yet, so we haven't had as much output last year as we usually do. Designing 3 years ahead, we do that for American Express, you could say also, but it's a little bit of a different case when you launch the site and you know it has to actually work now and then as well. But I think the tricks are to keep it simple. I think the Danish minimalism and functionalism, designing, trying to take out some of the, again, the fashion elements of web design, because you just know that that's not going to work that far into the future. The evergreens, look at how does nice design from the 80s or 60s or whatever look, using that as the references to work from, and then you will be more likely to have something that works in the future then. But we actually have a few things out there still where I think the design from our side has worked really well over time. We did this app for Uniqlo, the Japanese fashion brand. We did that in designed it in 2013 and it was out in 2014, so quite a long time ago now. I think it still looks perfectly up to date. I can't see how you wouldn't necessarily design that better today. We refrained from using the normal, you could say, iOS design for anything. We did everything custom, flattened out, simple. Because we did that, it's still working today. Awwwards are important in several different ways for an agency and for the people inside the agency. And we attract talent by winning awwwards. And I think that's a main driver, especially for getting application from outside of Denmark. It is the awwwards, that's the only touch point we have, you could say, with those potential talents. In that case, it's been extremely, extremely important for us. And then there is, of course, when you are employed here, it's just the recognition. It can be sometimes when you work on a project for 4 months You get so tired of it, you can't see how good it is. So it's really nice just to see other people from the outside think that it's super nice and that they dream of being on that team that you're on. It's the only way of really getting that unfiltered in some way, because you're measured against the competition. And we've been lucky enough to win two Side of the Year awards at Awwwards with the three W's in. I still don't know how to pronounce that. And we have like 27 FWAs. And for Creative Circle, which is the biggest award here in Denmark, we've also won that a lot. The Digital Design Agency of the Year last 2 years, and 17 circles, I think we have, which is quite a lot. So, and those are the main three ones for us. We also have won like Webbies and Lobbies and One Show and different things. A graphic designer, in my mind, that's more a person that works in the team here, not necessarily super client-facing. And in that case, you don't, in my mind, you don't even need to have worked on anything real yet. I can totally spot from a school project or whatever you would put in your own portfolio if you're good enough. And then there's the interviews where it's the chemistry. So we are a small company, so we sit very close together, so it's super important that we can just have a good time together. That is almost as important as your talent. So in my mind, I'm not looking at school diplomas, especially in the digital world where things move so fast that teachers, they can't follow because they spend time teaching instead. So what you can learn from the schools are the evergreens, like typography, color theories, layout, like really the old school kind of aspects of design. What you apply into making it interactive and up to date, you could say, is something that you learn on your own and from your fellow students or when you are at a workplace. I think you might as well have been thrown into a work situation or whatever instead of going to school, and you can easily be as good as anybody else. I think the best persons I can have at a company like this can do quite a lot of things good. But that's for several reasons. It's also for just booking resources and stuff. It's just really nice that you can actually put people on different roles. So we had developers that are really good at motion graphics as well. We have designers that are good at motion graphics and both can do UX, illustration and UI design. So those kind of, you could say, octopus roles where you can do more than one thing is extremely good. And I think actually the best talent just have a natural ability to do things good. Of course they can specialize and will be better at one thing, but often she or he can be better at the other things than most other people as well, right? So the curious type that has an eye for the aesthetic part of what we do, and then it can become anything. I don't think it's a necessary skill to have motion as a designer, but I think it's very important that you know about motion, that you know about movement, that you can see natural movement, and you know what an easing can do for things. Because I think we can strip down design with motion, so we can remove buttons and we can remove arrows and kind of these kind of things by moving things for the user. And it's kind of part of this generation of, you could say, the iOS of the iPhone kind of introduced, where focus on designing the software became such a new thing, you could say, that when you make a layer, you could see that it moves in over, and when you remove it, it moves away instead of just blinking in and out. That tells so much more of a story about where you are on the website. So with these kind of things, you can control the design a lot. And I think that's super important for the designer. They don't need to do After Effects. They don't need to be able to code any movement or anything. But that would be an added bonus, because sometimes it's just nice to also render stuff out and have it both to show the client, but also in the final project. There's several steps in for a young designer to kind of move into the agency world, I think. So what I actually did personally was, it's a long time ago now, it's 20 years ago, but I tried to copy other people because you couldn't find out how they did, you couldn't read it anywhere. So I just tried to do the same thing. And when I was good enough to do the same thing, I started doing my own thing. And then from that, you make the skill palette complete enough for you to actually do the things that you want to, and then you have some original work that you can show to a potential workplace. As with everything we do, it's about first impressions. Or it's the same as walking into a bar and finding that face in the crowd that kind of stands out. You need to curate your work, so you need to remove stuff that doesn't work. Doesn't have to be a lot of work in there. It's a simple thing, it's very few elements, and the people looking through the portfolios don't have a lot of time, so they won't look at 20 pieces of work unless you can scan it really, really quickly.
So that's it. Thank you so much for Pelle and the team at Spring Summer for letting me get into the office and annoy them for a couple of hours. And I hope you got to get some good stuff out of this interview, because I surely did. I have one more video coming up real soon with someone who works with insights and research, so maybe stick around for that one. And yeah, I don't really know what to say now. Like, comment, subscribe. Yeah, like, comment, subscribe. What is up, YouTube fam? It's so great to see your beautiful faces on this sunny day. And I have a special treat for you with this interview today, because I'm talking. No, we're not gonna do that stuff.